Subscribe and click on the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest videos.
Hi guys, welcome to JFW's Fortnite Questions, and today we are meeting Ganesh. Hi Ganesh, how are you today?
Hi brother. Enna bro, romba naala gym pakkame kaano. Vaanga, ore set podla.
Enak gymming la set aavadu bro.
Enna brother. Vaanga vaanga.
Neenga endha vayasula irundhu fitness aarambichinga?
Bro, na college la padichirundhen. I think I was about 17, 18. Appo sports la enakku uyir. I was the captain of my volleyball team college la. And I think on the time la you know all this MTV revolution, music videos paakkuradhu, modeling la paakkuradhu. So t-shirt pota nachana konja body irukano, arms irukano, chest irukano. And the time la dhaan konja gym poi aarambichen nenikiren. But because of the sports la background irundhadunala oru alavukku set aayiruchu adhu.
So what inspired you to choose this field?
Actually school la padikkumbodhu dramatics romba pidikum. Dramatics stage la perform pandrathu, annual day la perform pandrathu. But family pathinga, I belong to a middle class typical Tamil family in Mumbai. So nobody even remotely was in the film industry. So my first job was of a software programmer in a software company. 1 year into the job, I realized that I'm a creative person and I can't keep doing this 9-to-6 job all my life. That's when I thought modeling was a good way to enter the glamour industry, and I took part in the Gladrex Mr. India. And the contest jaichita, and then a whole new world opened in front of me.
In fact, the other next question I'm with you, what is your first break into media?
Adana, so it was Gladrex Mr. India. So overnight things changed for me. I was a software programmer. After winning that contest, I was sent for Mr. World to represent India with 92 countries. So nariya grooming, nariya preparation, you know, wardrobe vandu or a top designer pannaru. எப்படி க்யூஎன்ஏ ஹேண்டில் பண்ணுறது, எப்படி இந்தியாவோட ஒரு அம்பாசிடராக நான் போகிறேன், ஸோ ஹவு ஐ ஷுட் லைக் யூனோ இம்ப்ரெஸ் த பீப்புள் ஓவர் தேர். ஸோ தட் வாஸ் அ கிரேட் ட்ரைனிங். அண்ட் அதுலேருந்து வந்ததுக்கப்புறம் ஆட் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ், டெலிவிஷன் சீரியல்ஸ், மூவிஸ், எவ்ரி திங் ஹேப்பன்.
ஓ வாவ், தட்ஸ் அன் ஆசம் ஸ்டோரி. ஸோ அந்த டைம்ல டிட் யூ ஹேவ் எனி ரோல் மாடல் டு இன்ஸ்பயர் யூ?
ஆக்சுவலி நிறைய ரோல் மாடல்ஸ். பேக் இன் பாம்பே ஐ யூஸ் டு வாட்ச் லாட் ஆஃப் மணி சார்ஸ் மூவிஸ், லாட் ஆஃப் கமல் ஹாசன் சார்ஸ் மூவிஸ், ஹீரோஸ் லைக் Maddy, Arvind Sami, Rajni sir, these are all huge inspirations, yeah. And though I was born brought up in Bombay, my heart was like Tamil industry la or a pair padnao, I should establish myself there, go back to my roots. Appadi eppome irundhathu manasla.
Inga summer fit a irukinga, or naalik inga evlo neram work pannuvinga?
Na vandu I try to at least spend 1.5 hours, 2 hours working out every day. Na eppadi paakrena, I think நம்ம எல்லாருக்கும் கனவுகள் இருக்கு, ரைட்? வி ஆல் ஹேவ் ட்ரீம்ஸ். அண்ட் மெனி டைம்ஸ் த ஸ்பீட் பிரேக்கர் பிட்வீன் அஸ் அண்ட் ஆர் ட்ரீம்ஸ் இஸ் அவர் ஃபிசிக்கல் அண்ட் மென்டல் அபிலிட்டி. ஓகே, சில டைம் வந்து ஒரு டிசையர் இருக்கும், ஆனால் பாடியில் எனர்ஜி இருக்காது, இல்லை மென்டலி டிப்ரெஸ்டாக இருப்போம், ஸ்ட்ரெஸ்ஸாக இருப்போம். ஸோ டெய்லி இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு டிசிப்ளின், 1.5 hours ஒர்க் அவுட் பண்ணுறோன்னா அந்த எனர்ஜி லெவலும் வரும். ரெண்டாவது வந்து ஒர்க் அவுட் பண்ணும்போது இந்த எண்டோர்ஃபின் சொல்லுவாங்க, ஹாப்பி ஹார்மோன்ஸ், இது ரிலீஸ் ஆகும் பாடியில். You feel very relaxed, you feel happy automatically. So both mentally and physically I find working out. And adha enna venalum irukalam, adha gym mattu irukanumna avasiyam illa. So sometimes I do yoga, sometimes I do martial arts, swimming, some sport, and I think it really relaxes and balances you out.
Idla edhu unga favorite workout?
I think these days I really enjoy doing martial arts. So right now ஒரு அடுத்த ப்ரொஜெக்டாக ட்ரெயின் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கேன். ஸோ அதில் நிறைய ஆக்ஷன், இட்ஸ் அன் ஆக்ஷன் த்ரில்லர் பேசிக்லி.
ஸோ
நிறையா பஞ்சஸ், கிக்கு, கிக்ஸ், நிறையா ஆக்ஷன் இருக்குது, கொஞ்சம் எம்எம்ஏ எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் இருக்குது அதில். ஸோ ஆக்ஷன் கோரியோகிராஃபி இஸ் சம்திங் தட்ஸ் எக்ஸைட்டிங் மீ தீஸ் டேஸ்.
நீங்கள் ஒரு ஸ்போர்ட் ப்ரொஃபஷனலாக இருந்தால் எந்த ஸ்போர்ட் சூஸ் பண்ணுவீங்க?
ஐ திங்க் இட் பி வாலிபால், ஏன்னா ப்ரொஃபஷனலி ட்ரெயின் பண்ணியிருந்தேன். அண்ட் இப்போ சமீபத்தில் நாங்கள் வந்து துபாய் போயிருந்தோம் for CBL, Celebrity Badminton League, and it was very very professional. Nariya train panni ponom, and so I think it would be badminton or even lawn tennis for that matter.
So what is your latest obsession apart from gymming or working out?
Well, I enjoy dancing.
Oh wow.
Dancing is something that excites me, and I think it's very relaxing. And like I said, martial arts, action choreography, it's very much like fight composition is very much like a dance choreography, the way you know block each thing and the components of that. It's very interesting, actually.
If you have to describe yourself in two words,
just two words,
two adjectives, what would it be?
Well, I think one would definitely be awesomely cool, and I think the second thing is very dependable.
Hmm.
Okay, now I think I'm very sweaty. I'm going to go and take a quick shower.
Wait, wait,
I'm going to be right back.
We have a few more questions.
Hold on, buddy.
Okay, fine.
I'll get dressed, smart, dapper, and come back and answer all your questions.
Okay. Deal? Yes, done.
Cheers. Hello there.
Hi, Ganesh. We're back to ask you questions.
Sure.
So, the first question. What is the common misconception people have about you?
Common misconception? Well, you know, before Big Boss, people used to think that I'm this really short-tempered guy, this really tough guy. Probably it's because the movie roles that I did, like Unnai Polarova and stuff. But after Big Boss, or thanks to Big Boss, people know that I'm a really chilled out, really cool guy. So I think that misconception is broken now.
Okay. What is the one thing people don't know about you?
Well, நிறைய பேருக்கு தெரியாது that எனக்கு தமிழ் எழுத படிக்க தெரியும்.
ஓ வாவ். உங்க சின்ன வயசுல நீங்க என்னவா ஆகணும்னு ஆசைப்பட்டீங்க?
சின்ன வயசுல வந்து I was very influenced by cinema. ஒவ்வொரு படம் பார்க்கும்போது அந்த ஹீரோ என்ன பண்றாரு, என்ன தொழில் செய்யறாரு, அதுதான் எனக்கு செய்யணும்னு தோணும். In fact, once I went to see this movie called King Solomon's Mines. It was a treasure hunt மாதிரி இருந்தது. So ஹீரோட profession வந்து explorer. ஸோ வீட்டுக்கு போய் ஒரே ஆர்ப்பாட்டம். அப்பா கிட்ட வந்து ஐ வாண்ட் டு பி அன் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோரர், ஐ வாண்ட் டு. அப்போ அப்பா சொன்னார் இதுக்கு எந்த ஒரு குவாலிஃபிகேஷனே இல்லை. ஸோ அப்போ அப்போ அஸ் எ கிட் சில படங்கள் வந்து பார்த்து ஒரு ஏர் பைலட் ஆகணும்னு தோணிருக்கு, சில படங்கள் பார்த்து ஒரு கிரிக்கெட்டர் ஆகணும்னு தோணிருக்கு. இந்த மாதிரி சைல்ட்ஹுட் ஐ திங்க் ஐ ஹவ் பீன் வாண்டிங் டு பி சோ மெனி திங்ஸ். அண்ட் ஐ திங்க் நவ் தட் ஐம் அ ஃபிலிம் ஆக்டர் ஐ கேன் பிளே டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கேரக்டர்ஸ். அதை ஒரு வகையில் வந்து ஐ கேன் ஃபுல்ஃபில் நினைக்கிறேன்.
டு யூ ரிமெம்பர் ஹவ் யூ ஸ்டார்டட் இன் டு த ஃபிலிம் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி?
வெல், நிறையா பேருக்கு தெரியாத ஒரு விஷயம் இருக்குது. மெனி பீப்புள் திங்க் தட் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் த்ரூ அபியும் நானும். பட் ஆக்சுவலாக வந்து என்னோடய முதல் படம், இட் வாஸ் அ ஹிந்தி இங்கிலீஷ் கிராஸ் ஓவர் ஃபிலிம் கால் தி அங்கிரேஸ், ஷார்ட் இன் ஹைதராபாத். அண்ட் ஐ திங்க் டுடே, டில் டுடே இட்ஸ் அ கல்ட் ஃபிலிம். இட் வாஸ் அன் அமேசிங் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஷூட்டிங் ஃபார் தட் ஃபிலிம்.
அந்த படம் யாருனால எப்படி கிடச்சிதுன்னு சொல்ல முடியுமா அந்த கதை?
அது உண்மையிலே ஒரு இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங்கான கதை. நான் வந்து அப்போ மாடலிங் பண்ணிட்டு இருந்தேன். ஐ ஹட் ஆஸ்பிரேஷன்ஸ் டு பி அன் ஆக்டர், பட் ஃபார்மல் ட்ரெயின் ஆகலை. அப்போ என்ன ஆச்சுன்னா, ஐ காட் அ கால் ஒன் டே ஃப்ரம் அ கோஆர்டினேட்டர் சேயிங், கணேஷ் இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு படம். அண்ட் எப்படின்னா, ஹைதராபாத்தில் ஒரு செக்ஷன் இருக்கும், ஒரு பகுதி, ஓல்டு சிட்டி ஆஃப் ஹைதராபாத். அங்கே ஒரு ஒரு டிப்பிக்கல் ஆக்சென்டில் பேசுவாங்க ஹிந்தி. ஸோ அந்த அந்த ஏரியா சேர்ந்த சில பேர், அண்ட் ரெண்டு பேர் இவங்க வந்து என்ஆர்ஐ, தே கம் டு ஒர்க் இன் அ கால் சென்டர் இன் தி இந்தியா. ஸோ இவங்க இந்த ரெண்டு எக்லெக்டிக் குரூப்ஸ்க்கு நடுவில் நடக்கிற ஒரு கதை. ஸோ ஆக்சுவலி ஐ டு ஃபேக் அன் அமெரிக்கன் ஆக்சென்ட் இன் மை ஆடிஷன் டு கெட் த பார்ட். அண்ட் உண்மையிலே நம்பிட்டாங்க தட் ஐ அம் ஆக்சுவலி ஃப்ரம் த யூஎஸ். அண்ட் தோ ஐ ஹட் நாட் பீன் டு யூஎஸ் அட் தட் பாயிண்ட், அண்ட் ஐ காட் த ஃபிலிம், அண்ட் த ஃபிலிம் பிகேம் அ சூப்பர் டூப்பர் ஹிட்.
வுட் யூ மைண்ட் டூயிங் அஸ் அன் ஆக்சென்ட் நவ்?
ஸோ யா, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் வாட் மை கோஆர்டினேட்டர் டோல்ட் மீ, தட் யூ ஹவ் டு ஸ்பீக் டு த டிரெக்டர் ஆன் த ஃபோன். அவர் யூஎஸ்லேருந்து வராரு. ஸோ யூஎஸ் கால் இருந்தது ஆக்சுவலாக, அண்ட் ஐ ஹேவ் டு convince him. So now on the every accent fake panni, hello, so this is Ganesh Venkatraman. I studied my masters at the Pennsylvania State University. I've done my acting course, I've done my majors in acting, and I'd love to be a part of your film. And I know it's about an NRI, it's about a typically American born desi, and I'm exactly that, and I'd love to do this movie, man.
Wow.
That
is exactly like an American.
So I just faked an accent.
One role you're proud of?
Well, actually, the two roles actually. பொதுவாகவே ஒரு இண்டஸ்ட்ரியில் என்ட்ரி எப்படி பண்ணணும், ஒரு மிகப்பெரிய எல்லா அப்கமிங் ஆக்டர்ஸ்க்கு ஒரு கேள்விக்குரியான ஒரு விஷயம் எனக்கும் இருந்தது. ஏன்னா ஐ வாஸ் இன் பாம்பே, பார்ன் அண்ட் பிராட் அப் தேர். பட் தமிழ் ஃபிலிம் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி கூட குள்ள ஒரு ஐ டு கீப் மை ஃபீட், எப்படி பண்ண முடியும்? அப்போ தான் அபியும் நானும் வைஃப் வந்து என்னை தேடி பாம்பேயில் வந்தது. என்னை தேடின்னு சொல்ல முடியாது, நான் தான் தேடி போனேன். அந்த இப்போ பிரகாஷ் ராஜ், ராதா மோகன் சார் பற்றி கேள்விப்பட்டிருந்தேன். மொழி வாஸ் அ ஹிட். ஸோ முதல் முறையாக அவங்கள மீட் பண்ணும்போது நான் ஆக்சுவலாக ரிஜெக்ட் ஆகிட்டேன். ஏன்னா ரொம்ப க்ளீன் ஷேவனாக இப்படி தான் போயிருந்தேன். ஸோ ஐ திங்க் ராதா மோகன் சார் வந்து ஹீ குடன் சீ த கேரக்டர் இன் மீ. ஸோ ஹீ கேவ் மி வெரி நான் கமிட்டல், வீல் கெட் பேக் டு யூ டைப்ஸ்.
ஸோ மறுநாள் வந்து நான் ஆக்சுவலாக அந்த அந்த சர்தார்ஜி கெட்டப்பில் அந்த தாடியெலாம் போட்டு பகடியில் போட்ட குர்த்தாவில் ஒரு கடா போட்டுட்டு அப்படியே போய் நிற்கிறேன் ராதாமோகன் சருக்கு முன்னாடி. ஹெட் டு டோ அப்படியே சர்தார்ஜி மாதிரி இருக்கேன். அது மட்டும் இல்லாமல் I was a kid, so I was a kid. He died when my father was 15, right? So I never got to see him. But I've heard so many stories about his police la irkumbodhu idu pannirkaru adu pannirkaru. He was also with the secret service. So nariya avaroda kadhaigal padichirundhen. And unne pole oru van pannumbodhu enoda inspiration vandu tata da. Avaru vandu indha situation eppadi handle pannirpaar appadi adu yosichu romba oru passionate pannina oru vishayam. So and adu vandu it rebounded with the audience also, Arif Khan in UPO. So I'll always be very proud of that.
One favorite co-star.
Favorite co-star, one co-star. I wish I could say Kamal sir, but I never got to share a frame with Kamal sir. Unne polar one nenu paathina engaloda scene will be different places happening at different places of time.
Correct.
So I would say a co-star, my role model, somebody I grew up watching was Amitabh Bachchan, and I got to play his son in a movie called Kandahar. And he was such a delight to work with, and I actually felt like he was my father. On the set, there was no actor thing. I looked at him only, that father figure thing comes inside you. And the kind of stories he shared with me, the advice he gave me, on screen, off screen, he's phenomenal. So I would say Amitabh Bachchan, and in heroines, I would say Trisha. Obviously, because she's a very, very dear friend. She was my first heroine when I stepped my feet into the industry, and she was so supportive, nothing like a big star. She was absolutely down to earth. Then I did another movie also with her, so I think Trisha.
Okay. What do you learn from Amitabh Bachchan or Trisha? Like, from both of them, what was your learning?
Well, I think Trisha is a very balanced person. She, I really like the fact that she enjoys what she does. You know, she's very happy about her work. Amitabh ji, I think is the advice that he gave me. Avar kuda Kandahar padathle nadikkum bodhu, he told me, Ganesh, as an entertainer, platform is irrelevant. As long as the work excites you, whether it's a small screen, big screen, whether it's stage, radio, do everything. Appo vandu digital media had not come, you know, web series and digital platforms had also not evolved. But he told me, tomorrow personal space will come, you should still do it. So I remember after I took this advice, I came back and I decided from that day that I should be an actor, not just on the big screen. I should be in all mediums. I should do theater on stage. I should do be a part of television. I should do something on radio. I should host, not just act. And also, I should work across languages. So I took his advice literally, and I think versatility is what I learned from him.
What is the one thing you learned from Kamal sir?
Well, I think Kamal sir's pursuit of excellence. அவர் ஒரு விஷயம் பண்ணார்னா அதில் பர்ஃபெக்டாக இருப்பார். அவரோட பேஷன் என்ன, ஹீ இஸ் அ ரியல் லீடர் இன் எவ்ரி சென்ஸ். பிகாஸ் அவரோட யூனிட்டில் சீயிங் த வே ஹீ ஒர்க்ஸ், ஹீ செட்ஸ் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள், எவ்ரிபடி யூ நோ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபாலோஸ் ஹிம் அண்ட் டேக்ஸ் தட் எனர்ஜி அண்ட் இட் லீட்ஸ் டு அ ஃபினாமினல் ப்ராடக்ட்.
ஒன் டைரக்டர் யூ விஷ் டு ஒர்க் வித்?
Well, I think for any actor coming into the Tamil industry, it's always a dream to work with Mani sir and Shankar sir. Because the way they mount their characters, their stories, their films, I think it's amazing. They are legends. So I would really love to work and learn from them.
What is the last movie you watched?
Well, I'm a huge fan of Tala. So last one, for the second time, Vishwasam paathen. And Saloye Vanda, Ajit sir just rocked in the film. And as a fan, I think I'm completely satisfied.
Who do you think is creating sensational waves in recent times? Like your favorite recent hero?
Waves. I think on the music space, I think Sid Sriram is phenomenal. He's like our Tamil Arjit Singh. He's just everywhere and I love his compositions. And well, surprising, another actor who's creating space is, I think, Talaivar, Rajni sir. I mean, 2.0 just got released a couple of months back and we all loved him in that. And here comes Peta and he's just rocked in the film. I mean, every frame, you can see his energy. You can see whether it's action, dance, comedy, romance. It's like a textbook, you know, watching that actor on screen and learning from him, enjoying. It's phenomenal. He's really sensational.
Who do you wish to pair up in your next film?
Pair up. Well, there are so many heroines that I would love to work for. The longest time, I think I've been wanting to work with Tamanna. And there's so many good performers. There's Varu, who's a dear friend. There's Rashi Khanna. There's Kajal. I think the list is endless. But you know what? I'm really hungry. I'm going to get myself a sandwich. Can I fix you one too?
Yes, I would love it.
Okay, come.
Sandwich with Ganesh Venkatraman. So, what's your favorite breakfast?
My favorite breakfast, I generally am a smoothie person. So, I make a power shake in the morning, which comprises of a lot of fruits, some dry fruits, some protein powder, and I just mix all of it up and create a nice smoothie for myself.
Do you have a cheat diet? You're like always into fitness, but I'm sure you have a cheat diet.
Hey, you know what? I'm a foodie. I love food. And yes, to maintain your physique, you have to be disciplined. But I allow myself one day in a week. Generally, it's a Sunday. I call it my cheat meal day. So already I make lists of places that I want to visit, the kind of cuisine I want to try. And of course, I have my partner in crime, Nisha, who's a fellow foodie. And then we just go and indulge in the food that we enjoy. But that's just once, one day in a week.
Okay. How often do you cook at home?
How often I cook at home? That's a good question. I don't really cook much besides fixing some oats or a sandwich like this or a smoothie. Maybe green tea sometimes. That's all I cook. Otherwise, it's Nisha who's doing the cooking. And she's a fabulous cook.
Oh, so clearly she's the better cook then.
Here's your sandwich. Enjoy.
Oh, awesome.
Tell me how.
Thank you. Yes, of course. Looks yummy. How did you and Nisha meet?
How did I and Nisha meet? Long story. Well, I have to give credit to Kala Master for that. So there was this reality show on TV happening. It was called Vendar Veet Kalyanam. It was about, you know, couples who are engaged, who are going to get married to test their compatibility. So Kala Master called me and she said that I'm going to be the host and the judge of the show. And they were looking for a co-host. That's when Nisha had just finished hosting Sun Singer and they got her to co-host the show along with me. That's where we met for the first time. And we became really good friends and there was this very special vibe about her. And eventually friendship turned into love.
Huh. Define love.
Define love. Huh. Well, I don't know. I think love is something that you should experience more than defined, but it's a certain kind of sweetness of emotion, I would say. I think the beautiful thing about love is everyone has his own definition, right? To me, I would say love is companionship. Having somebody with you who cares for you all the time, sharing your life with someone, that to me is love. No.
What is the one thing you love about Nisha?
There are many things, but one thing is she's a very compassionate person. She's very, very selfless and caring. I really love that about her.
One thing you don't like about Nisha?
She can get angry fast sometimes.
The best thing Nisha has ever surprised you with?
So on our engagement, many of my relatives couldn't come to Chennai because it was a very, like our parents met and they decided that let's do a very informal ring ceremony. So many of my relatives from the US, Bangalore, many other places, they couldn't come. So what Nisha did is without my knowledge, she went and took everyone's video bites and made a lovely edit. She's a Viscom student, so it was a very professional edit. And on the day of the engagement, after we exchanged rings, on the big screen, she played it. And up until then, I was missing the presence of all of those people on that occasion. But when I saw them,
my face just lit up and I had tears in my eyes. It was very, very emotional.
That's so sweet. So how are you planning to celebrate Valentine's Day?
Valentine's Day, now that should be a surprise, right? I'm not going to tell you. Valentine's Day is a very, very special day. And Nisha loves surprises. So I'm going to look up some nice places in Chennai. Chennai always has some new places mushrooming every other month. So let's see what beautiful romantic places there that I can take her to this time.
What's the craziest thing you guys have done together?
Together? So on my honeymoon, I made a jump off the plane. So skydiving. So both of us are adventure freaks. I am actually much more wilder and freakier. But I think I can give her the right push. She's also an adventurer at heart. So we both in Dubai, there's this over Dubai Marina, there's your skydiving. It's probably one of the most beautiful views because when you jump from the plane, you see the entire shape of the Palm Jumeirah and the entire view of Dubai is beautiful. So we did that on our honeymoon and all my friends said, "Enna paithiyama pudichirukku honeymoon la poi aeroplane la kudikringa." So it was really wild.
What kind of places do you like to travel to?
Well, both of us like traveling and we like exploring cultures. So our choice of places is dependent upon where we're going to go on foot and explore cultures. We're not those typical touristy couples who just goes, wants to be in the hotel and enjoy. Adhu vandhu namma oorliye pannalam. So out of all my travels, I've really loved Australia and New Zealand because of the nature's beauty that is there. And we did a lot of trekking and a lot of adventure sports because New Zealand has Queenstown, which is the adventure capital of the world. So from bungee jumping to high speed boat to rafting, canoeing, you can do it everything. My last anniversary, we went to Paris, which is the romantic capital of the world. That was beautiful. And Thailand was beautiful for shopping and food. So we've got a whole eclectic mix of places that we really love.
What was your oh my god moment with Nisha so far?
Oh my god. Okay, when I took her to New Zealand, Vijay sir vandu kushi padathla paathirupinga andha bungee jumping pannuvaru.
Yeah.
So when I was planning the trip, I told Nisha that this is the oldest bungee jumping place. It's called the Kawara Bridge bungee jump. It started in 1940s or 50s. We have to do this. She was not very confident, so I convinced her that instead of jumping one by one, we'll jump together, we'll tie our legs together. It's called as like the couple bungee jump.
Wow.
And I booked us on that. Till the very last minute, she was not confident. And I was like, dhairyam kudutte irne. And then we finally jumped. And I was so happy that, she trusted me. And I said, Nisha, I love you. I jumped and we jumped and on the recoil, spontaneously, I just kissed her. And the camera captured that beautifully. And whenever I replay that, it sends goosebumps, that's always been my OMG moment.
Okay, now we're going to move on to rapid fire questions. That means...
Let's do it.
You have to answer really fast.
Okay, without thinking.
Yes, without thinking.
Top of my mind.
Yes. Tea okay. Or coffee?
Coffee.
Beard or no beard?
No beard.
Box office or critically acclaimed?
Definitely box office.
Mumbai or Chennai?
Chennai.
What's the greatest thing about Chennai?
I think Chennai is very balanced. It doesn't have a maddening pace like Bombay. So you get a lot of me time here.
Where do you usually hang out in Chennai?
Will be Palazzo because that's close to my place and I watch all my movies there.
What is the first thing you think of when you come home?
My wife, Nisha.
What is the wildest thing Ganesh has done in his entire life?
Wildest thing? That will be while I was in Australia trying out kangaroo meat, crocodile meat, rabbit meat. I tried everything. I've never been that wild anywhere else.
What's your favorite part of being in Big Boss?
So well, everybody knows, so what Big Boss is about is putting different kind of people in a situation and creating a conflict and seeing how they react, right?
Yeah.
So when I was in Big Boss, they tried to create so much conflict to see who gets irritated, who gets tense, who gets, they try every permutation combination, but they couldn't touch me, man. I was cool in all situations.
What is the best compliment you have received in your entire life?
I think post Big Boss, I have received the maximum compliments that I've ever got. And what's more special is because I've got it for the person that I am. People said I was a true gentleman the way I treated women. They said that I was very cool and calm and handled all situations
in a composed way where others were abusing and getting angry. And lots and lots of compliments here.
The best piece of advice?
Well, to any newcomer that who's entering the industry, I would just tell you that, see, today we are living in an age where there's so much negativity around. We're always surrounded with negative opinions. Make sure that you don't let anyone else decide whether you can or cannot do something, right? You should be the only one to decide what you want to make out of your life. And I think if you're entering the media field, what's more important is to be the best version of yourself. Find out something that's unique. Because actors always work because every actor is unique from the other person. And on a general basis, I would tell all the young guys watching this show, because this is JFW and we have the World's Women Day coming. We all know the kind of problems the women in our city are facing, whether it's safety issues or abuse issues. I think it's important for us men to set a precedent. So don't just build your bodies or build your personalities, build your character too. Show women what a true gentleman is. Set your limits, treat women right, and let's make this a beautiful world for them, and we really owe this to them. And lots and lots of love. It was amazing catching up with you guys.